Two bandits are approaching this airfield. We are back in virtual reality. We are back in the F4 with all its detail, and this feels amazing. We need to take off as quickly as possible as these bandits are coming in very hot.
Canopy down and locked, lights out, stripes aligned.
Alright, let's take off. RPM at 85%, releasing the brakes, and let's roll out.
Engine's good, airspeed off the peg.
Thank you, Jester. Here we are rolling out until we hit 80 knots, and then I will put the stick back.
80 knots. 100 knots. I counted.
Alright, putting the stick back here, rotating. Ah, this never gets old.
Heads up, nails, 5 o'clock.
That's our teammate, nothing to worry about. Again, this feels great. Gear up.
Gears moving.
Gears up, flaps up.
Flaps up.
Check, thank you, Jester, for confirming.
Gear up.
Check, and oh, here on the RWR, we can see the two bandits coming in hot from the 11 o'clock. We are going for a low approach, and just look at the detail here. The blue water, the ships, it's fantastic. Okay, let's get the plane ready. Let's put ourselves in air-to-air mode over here, and make a left turn. Putting the bandits on my 12 o'clock here. Okay, I am leveling out here, and what we can't forget, of course, is to switch on the master arm, making sure that all the pylons are armed, and just sitting back here, and of course, testing the tone. Heat seekers are ready to be fired, great, and I will be banking a little bit to the left here, making sure that these bandits are on my 12 o'clock, and we are flying over open waters here, protecting international shipping here. And yeah, it looks fantastic. Let me just look, take a look on the right here, see if I can see the mountains in the distance. Yes, we can, and I like the reflection of the sun in the water. Taking a look in the left here, on the left you can see all the scratches in the cockpit. The light here in the cockpit, it's absolutely fantastic, people. Now let me see if I can see these bandits somewhere. No, I really can't see them yet. Well, there is something that perhaps might help you in seeing these bandits earlier. Then we have the sponsor for today. If you struggle to read indicators or normally wear glasses, but you know, not in VR, I highly recommend trying out the latest prescription lenses from VRWave.store. They prevent damage to the VR lenses because you don't have to wear glasses, which I was always worried about, and it will reduce eye strain with a blue light filter. So I don't want to sound like a billboard, but I really wish I had done this sooner. So if you're interested, visit VRWave.store. All right, back in the plane here. I am trying to spot the enemy planes. Now I cheated a little bit. I have turned on the labels, but I did this so that you can better see where the enemies are and what I am looking at. I can't find...
We have a 5 o'clock.
Oh, well, that's my teammate, Jester. Don't worry. Still really can't see the enemies here. And this is, of course, the beauty of VR, that I can just move my head around all over the place, trying to spot them. And I think, I believe, I can see the enemy bandits up ahead, above the clouds. At least I can see the labels here. That's the cheat. Going to drop the fuel tank here. Now, this is not the way you do it, but it's the easiest way for me to do it here. And it looks like that they don't see me. We are below the clouds. I am going up in the vertical, trying to get on their six. Heat-seeking missiles are armed. I've got tone. I just need... Oh, wait a second. We have a problem here. The sun is going to be a big problem, I think. Yeah, we get this shitty tone. Alright, I need to figure out which target I'm going for here. I'm going for this one. Got tone! Fox 2! We've got a Fox 2 off here. And that Fox 2 seems to be tracking. I need to focus on the other target here. Trying to get it into my reticle here. The right one. We got tone! Not a Fox 2! Another Fox 2 off here. It's tracking again. Not sure if we got the other target down. Let me take a look. Yeah, Splash 1! Splash 1! This other missile, by the way, is not tracking here on this other target. He's flaring. Let me try to see. It got turned. Fox 2 once more. Fox 2 once more. It's tracking. Good track. Oh.
Splash.
Splash bandit. Splash 2. Splash 2. That were the bandits. Bye-bye, suckers. We got them both in the intercept here. And there they go. Look at the effects here. They're both going down. What an amazing view this is. Although, hold on 1 second. Oh, no. He's in the water. Oh,
Yeah, this feels cute.
This is, by the way, a standard mission that you can also fly. It is on the Persian Gulf. It's called Intercept, something like that. Intercept mission. Pretty cool mission. And what we are going to do now is clean up here a little bit. And then we are flying back towards the airbase and try to land this beauty. I can switch off the master arm here. You don't need to be armed. There's no dangers around. I'm going to put it into the cage mode. Standby. Oh, no. No standby. I'm going to put it in the cage mode. There we go. And then we are going super fast. Now, the runway is a bit hard to spot, but it's in between those mountains up there. And for the ones that don't know, I am playing with the Pimax Crystal here. Currently, I am not playing with the eye tracking enabled, because otherwise the screen will get quite blurry. But even with my current PC setup, with the Pimax Crystal not having eye tracking enabled, I still have the maximum FPS, which is absolutely fantastic. The runway is on the right here. We need to extend the speed brakes here. There we go, because we are going way too fast. Banking to the right. Going final into the runway that we need to land on. Should be straight ahead now. Oh, a little bit more to the right, by the way. Over there. I feel I always have a little bit of difficulties landing the plane. Now, I can put the gear down for more drag. We are going 300 knots here. Let me just pull the gear down. Now, for some reason, I can never extend the flaps anymore. I don't know if I break them during my flight. Oop, gear down. There we go. Yeah, for some reason, I just can't get the flaps down. I don't know why. And I also have a little bit of difficulties landing the plane here, as it will, at around 200 knots, it just falls down. It just falls down from the air. I can't get it to work. So I need to be around 250 and just look at the scenery here. I love the reflection of the mountains in the water.
Alrighty, gear, flaps, pressure, warning lights, anti-skid.
Okay, yeah, it says that the flaps are down, but they are not down. We just have a very nice approach here. I hope I can have a butter smooth touchdown here. Maybe even what I like the most, you know, just learning the plane, learning how to turn it on, cold and dark, taking off and landing. I mean, the combating is fine, and the dogfighting, but this is also amazing. Fantastic.
1,000.
All right, 1,000. We are going around 250 knots here, close to 300. It's way too fast, of course, but hey, it will do. Landing gear is down. Check. We can see the harbor here, the blue water on the left.
500.
500. Check. Getting closer, getting closer. Runway inside.
300.
300, check, very well aligned. Easy.
100.
100, check. Flaring. I would say great. Great.
Yeah, with a landing like that, you could park it in suburbia.
Thank you, Jester. I appreciate the positivity. Yeah, one of the better landings until now. Very smooth. We are just going to break it here. I am not going to use the parachute here. Very long runway here. I can just use the brakes, although it might not be the best. Overheating them, whatever. Just trying to stop the plane here. There we go. The screeching noises. Opening the canopy here. And welcome home, everyone. I hope you enjoyed this video. Thank you, Jester, for all your help. And yeah, let me know if you like this video. Super immersive scenario, really like it. And as always, yeah, I mean, I hope to see you with me in my next flight. Ciao, ciao, guys. Bye-bye.